Matthew Community Theater's Fall Concert Fundraiser. I appreciate it. Hopefully everyone had a chance to visit our silent auction in the hall, which is filled with items from our generous donors. If you haven't had a chance, go ahead and swing by during intermission, bid on the best seats in the house for our Fall 2020 show, or a basket that would make any sport fan impressed. After our 15-minute intermission, we will hear from a representative from the community organization that we've decided to donate a portion of our proceeds from tonight to. It's called the Sheridan Project, and she will speak to you later on. Note by Note, From Bricks to Broadway, is a review of SMCT's last 6 years. When I approached our staff about a fall concert, I pitched an evening where artists and audience members alike could relive some of the moments that made them love our theater, roles that people felt. I hope tonight, while you hear selections from the musicals that brought us here, that you see more than just the amazing talent of these performers, but that you get a chance to feel. Feel what they love about those roles, what you loved about those shows, and feel excitement for the magic of what we will create next. Now, without further ado, here to lead us on this journey down memory lane is our director, Vanessa McGowan-Horrocks-Power.
In 2014, my friend Sarah Meyer, then Sarah Tolbert, said that St. Matthew Lutheran Church was looking for a new director for their annual spring musical. My feelings about theater were conflicted at the time. I had gone to school for it, and my experience had been a mix. But it was an opportunity to do art and meet people, so I took it. I was like Dorothy, living unsatisfied in a sepia-toned artistic rut. And then a tornado came along and blew me on an adventure that would change my life forever. I was transported to a strange place over the rainbow, or in this case, under the sanctuary, where the world moved in bright, vibrant color, and the people had the smarts, the hearts, and the courage to make truly awesome art. At the end of my journey, I found that I, like Dorothy, had found a new definition of home.
I could while away the hours, confirming with the flowers, consulting with the rain.
When you're born to be a sissy without the vivid fire. But I can show my prowess, be a lion, not a mouse, if I don't the answer. Picture me, a balcony, above the voice sings low.
Wherefore art thou, Romeo?
I hear a beat. Just a dandelion, a fate I can't explain.
And perhaps I deserve you, and be even worthy of you if I only had a brain.
Chose to register emotion like jealousy, devotion, and really feel the part. I could stay young and chipper, and I'd lock it with a zipper. If I only had a heart.
A brain.
A nerd.
At the end of Wizard of Oz, as the group sat around Two Stooges, a favorite cast hangout, eating pizza, and basking in the glow of our accomplishments, we started to discuss what show could possibly follow up the triumph that was our trip to Oz. It took us quite a long time to settle on Pirates of Penzance, a show that was near and dear to my heart, but that most folks were unaware of. Our journey started out rather like a sea voyage, rocky and unpredictable. Pirates, as it turned out, was a difficult show to sing. It was an operetta. As our ships kept tan, there was no doubt in my mind that the extremely talented, hardworking folks at St. Matthew would rise to the occasion. And rise we did, all together, a rollicking band of pirates we. Our production of Pirates of Penzance featured an ambitious level of stagecraft and costuming, along with some of the highest notes and quickest lyrics ever attempted in that gymnatorium so far.
Month as February, 28 days as a rule are plenty, though maybe too many still. 1 year and every 4, his days shall be reckoned as 29. Through some singular coincidence, I shouldn't be surprised if it were owing to the agency of an ill-natured fairy. You are the victim of this clumsy arrangement, having been born in leap year on the 29th of February. And so, by a simple arithmetical process, which I had no help with whatsoever, no matter what she says, you will easily discover that though you've lived 21 years, in fact, if we go by birthdays, technically, you're only 5 and a little bit over.
Dear me, let's see. Yes, with yours my figures do agree.
common sense she gave me was. Yet counting in the usual way, here's 21 I've been alive. Yet reckoning by my natal day. Yet reckoning by my natal day. I am a little boy of five.
It's a little boy of five. A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox. A paradox, a curious paradox. A most ingenious paradox.
Even the fastest song. All right, so now that we have proved to the world and ourselves that we could sing with the best of them, we needed the new challenge that Seven Brides for Seven Brothers provided. Challenge dance, anyone? The brides, brothers, and suitors of that year will remember extensive dance rehearsals ranging in many styles. Ballet, country, boy band moves, if you were the brothers, one, two, three, I'm on a wagon. That's right, it wasn't enough to sing with the best of them, we had to dance with the best of them too. This was the first year where I started to develop my creative vision. The brothers represented the seven deadly sins, the brides the seven heavenly virtues, and they had a color palette to match. Simple, but effective. It was also the year that our leading lady got mono, and Renee reminded everyone that she's still queen of the stage by stepping in with 2 weeks before performances. Seven Brides for Seven Brothers was a particularly special year to me, as it features seven weddings the same year my own life featured one very important one, mine.
Whoa. So, you ask her for a stroll, and then you tell her how pretty she is. Then you call her, my dear, my darling, my precious, my pet. Go and court, go and court, oh, it sets your senses in a whirl. Go and court, go and court, dudin' up to go and see a girl. Oh, it's fun to hunt and shoot a gun, or to catch a rabbit on the run. But you find it twice as sport, go and court. You sidle up and squeeze her hand. Ooh, let me tell you, fellas, that is grand. You hem and haw a little while. She gives you kind of half a smile. You cuddle up, she moves away. Then the strategy comes into play.
If in you
to bend your knee and take that vow, cause I'm telling you now, you're the gal for me. Pretty and trim, but not too slim. Heavenly eyes and just the right size. She's gotta be right to be the bride for me. Bless her beautiful hide, wherever she may be.
Intermission time, which means that you have about 15 minutes to use the restroom, refresh your drinks, bid on items in the silent auction, and then
eat desserts.
I know, I thought some people already had it. Eat some desserts, and then come back in time for the speaker from our partner organization. And just so you all know, silent auction items end at the end of. Bidding ends at the end of intermission. So if you see something you like, now's the time to swipe it up. And thanks so much for the first half so far.
All right, thank you guys. Hopefully you all enjoyed intermission. The bidding on the silent auction looked amazing. So thank you so much and got some desserts. Right now, we're going to hear from the representative from the Sheridan Project. So.
Good evening. How's everyone doing?
Good.
I'm sorry I don't have a song to sing for you. This whole time, I was like, I wish we had a jingle that we could sing for you, but we don't. Well, my name is Abiba. I am from the Sheridan Story, and we are a local nonprofit. We've been here on Sunday morning before as well. We're excited when we were invited to come this evening. So we are a nonprofit that started in the 2010 school year in Sheridan Elementary, which is in northeast Minneapolis. And we became aware of a food insecurity issue inside the building from the principal. And there's a church that meets in that building still today. And the pastor and the principal had a conversation. And the principal said, we have a problem. We've got kids that are living in food insecurity, and we know this because these students are taking home their lunches on Friday in fear that they won't have food all weekend. And so they asked us if there's anything that we could do, and we said yes, we will give them a bag of food to take home. And we knew that that model of partnering the churches and the schools back together was successful, and so we decided to make that our main model moving forward. And so as a Sheridan Story, we take care of everything the church would have to do on their own, such as go shopping for the food, bag the food, get it packed, figure out how to get the school to trust you to come in and put food in kids' lockers and all those fun details. We take care of all those things. And so from that school year, we now just started this school year in 215 schools in the Twin Cities. Kids a week right now. And this is a huge growth, and it's all because of the community organizations, the churches, the nonprofits that we work with. So the nonprofits and the churches commit to helping with funding the program. As she mentioned, a portion of the proceeds from tonight are going to go to Highland and Elementary here in the community. There are over 75 kids that are on our program at Highland, and so it's a really big deal, and every dollar that you're giving towards is going to go to feed amazing kids in your own community. And so we're just really thankful that we were able to come. I do have some brochures out in the chair out here before you leave tonight if you'd like to pick one up. You also can visit our website, which is on the back of the brochure, thesheridanstory.org. I know that not everyone is going to be able to come and serve at the school on a Friday afternoon, but if you are interested, we do have packing events at our warehouse every other Thursday evening. Who's been to Feed My Starving Children?
Woo! Woo-hoo!
I used to work there, so I think they're awesome. We have packing events that are very similar to Feed My Starving Children. And we have very high energy. We're packing the bags. We're getting the bags ready to get to the kids and to the families. We have 5 different options that we offer our families based on cultural and dietary preferences. And so we definitely need help this school year to pack those bags up and to get it to all of these schools. And so those are every other Thursday evening from 6:30 to 8:30. We invite you and your family, your congregation, whoever you'd like to bring with you to come out and to serve together. So if you have any questions, feel free to, my email's on the website. Be happy to connect with you. But I just thank you so much for your generosity this evening. It is so difficult when we have large schools sometimes to find communities to serve together. And so I'm just so encouraged at what you're doing and the heart that you have to feed the kids in your own backyard. So thank you so much. And thanks for this amazing concert tonight.
I thought you'd seen the last of me. All right. How to put into words the absolute paramount production that was Beauty and the Beast. It was a year of firsts. It was our first year doing 2 weekends of shows. It was our first year advertising our show and auditions on Minnesota Playlist. It was our first year hosting over 100 auditions, and it was our first year with a cast cap, which we foolishly set at 75 people. If you didn't see the show, you did miss out. But try to imagine 75 people on that little stage. But on that little stage, we made big magic. That's the only word for it. It was absolute magic. The way that people came together to overcome those big first lessons we were learning the hard way, the way the visual language of the storytelling integrated so completely into the artistic vision and the performance of this tale as old as time really changed my life again. While each previous year had represented a foundational step in our growth as a community theater, this year was a giant, wonderful leap that really transformed us into a bigger, better, more artistically oriented group. Magic.
Me, the wife of that boorish, brainless Madame Gaston, can't you just
flies, love, a lost illusion.
coat was another big year. Our recent expansion brought in loads of new talent, and we tried a few shakeups in the artistic team. More than that, for me, Joseph was about Ben Hugo. I don't usually make shows about just one person or another, but Ben somehow represented our whole theater community in this strange year of flux.
Yeah, Ben Hugo!
He had grown up in the church, but suddenly found himself with a big show on his shoulders, surrounded by friends and new faces alike. We all watched him grow up that year, something that he'd been doing for quite some time, but none of us had really noticed. Suddenly, there was little Ben Hugo with this big voice and his big heart beating so loudly that we all had to take notice. Our little Ben was a grown-up, and our little theater that could, a real company with expectations and responsibilities and new opportunities. Our production of Joseph was also all about Minnesota. If you had the pleasure of seeing the show, you can safely say that you never have, and never will, see another production quite like it. We set it in our fair state, with Egypt set at the state fair. Each brother sported a Minnesotan personality quirk, and Pharaoh sang in the style of Bob Dylan rather than the traditional Elvis. We discovered a new level of creativity and execution of high artistic concept in our take on this classic.
Takes me a man who knows.
terrified. The show was charming, and I cried my eyes out just reading the script, but it was difficult and astonishingly popular. It attracted as many new faces as it did returning ones, and some of the faces I'd grown accustomed to seeing were conspicuously absent. It felt like Oz all over again. What was I doing? Who was I kidding? What was my brilliant idea that was gonna make Big Fish something that could rival the sheer brilliance of Minnesotan Joseph? Deep breath. It was, to me, our best year yet. Never had I related so strongly to the content of a show. A larger-than-life person who used stories to connect with other people, so much so that occasionally he struggled to do so without a story to rely on. That sounded familiar. And our brilliant twist. Well, we told the story really well. I learned that I didn't always have to hide behind a gimmick or dress a show up as something that it wasn't, or go against the grain of the original material to create meaning. We could do a great production with a blend of new and old friends, slick dance moves, heart-wrenching performances, artistic flourishes, and some candid, insightful directing, if I do say so myself. And the daffodil petals falling from the ceiling didn't hurt either.
What's your concern? Are you scared of hearing one thing new? And you can learn something secret that can help you through in one good turn. I can show you kind of it from truth. I begin.
Thank you.
why they get set up for our big reveal. I have last minute things to say. So officially, thank you all so much for coming to share this evening with us and to support us in our theater. But I also have a couple more special thanks. A special thanks to all of these amazing performers who donated their time, their talents to reprise some of the roles that have meant so much to them and to us. For orchestrating all of the food, the volunteers, and all of the tickets.
Yeah, Carol!
To Jackie for her incredible talents organizing our silent auction and promoting the fundraiser. To Kevin and to James for their time and the equipment to make all of this such an incredible success. Incredibly talented pianist, Karrie. Yeah. And our music director extraordinaire, Anissa. And of course, last but not least, to Vanessa, our director, whose drive, vision, and passion has helped us grow. Before we get into the next one, I do want to mention that the silent auction has closed. If you won, it's going to be posted up here on the door, so take a look on your way out after that. So speaking of growth, on to our next challenge. Here is Vanessa with the show announcement.
So here's the part where I say what show we're doing. I had totally written an amazing pun playing on time stops and time steps that I was planning to use as a segue, but Abigail didn't think I was super hilarious, so I decided to go in a different direction.
I would have thought it was funny.
Thanks, Christie! Over the course of this evening, you heard me say and seen for yourself the amazing performances we've produced, as well as our growth as a company into more ambitious shows with more opportunity for both nuance and spectacle. How we doing? Should I talk slower?
No, you're good.
Okay. There's something else about St. Matthew Community Theater, something more intangible, that anyone who's been a part of this group will try to explain to you. Some of us do it better than others, and while I have my moments of brilliant articulation, obviously, sometimes I find that my work, my art, speaks more eloquently than I do. That being the case, I made a little art to share with you all to try to get at this intangible, wonderful thing we all share here. A fellowship, a comradeship, a community, where theater is for everyone to share.
Shaking hands, the crowds and stands went wild. We were the kings and the queens, and they read off our names. The night you danced like you knew our lives would never be the same. You held your head like a hero book page. It was the end of a decade, but the start of an age. Long live. Yeah. traded your baseball cap for a crown. When they gave us our trophies, and we held them up for our town. And the cynics were outraged, screaming, this is so sad. Children someday.